हेलो एवरीवन। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट कंसेप्ट ऑफ टोटल कंफाउंडिंग एंड पार्शियल कंफाउंडिंग एंड देन वी डिस्कस अबाउट टोटल कंफाउंडिंग इन 2q फैक्टोरियल एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हेन वी कंफाउंड हाईएस्ट ऑर्डर इंटरैक्शन इफेक्ट इन 1 रेप्लिकेट एंड 4 रेप्लिकेट्स। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस पार्शियल कंफाउंडिंग इन 2q फैक्टोरियल एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड statistical analysis of this 2q factorial experiment when highest order interaction effect ABC is totally confounded in R replicates. So first we will discuss partial confounding in 2q factorial experiment. So in this 2q factorial experiment we use partial confounding. It means that from that particular replicate we delete effect of that interaction effect. So this is layout of 2q factorial experiment when AB is confounded in replicate 1 and AC is confounded in replicate 2. So in 2q factorial experiment we have 4 interaction effect: AB, AC, BC and ABC. So here we consider only 2 replicates, and in first replicate we consider ABC as a confounded effect, and in replicate 2 AC is a confounded effect. So here consider this 2q factorial experiment with ABC. These are the factor and each factor is at 2 levels. So we have total 8 number of treatment combinations: 1 A B, AB, C, AC, BC and ABC. So here we confound this AB interaction effect in replicate 1. So when we confound any effect, first we divide that replicate into 2 number of blocks. So in 2q factorial experiment we divide replicate into 2 block, and after that we assign positive and negative treatment combinations into each block. So here first we write down formula for interaction effect AB. So AB is 1 by 4 A minus 1 into B minus 1 into C plus 1. Just simplify these 3 brackets. So we get AB equals to 1 by 4 ABC minus BC plus AB minus B minus AC plus C minus A plus 1. Okay. So here in interaction effect AB, ABC, AB, C and 1. These are the positive treatment combinations, and BC, B, AC and A, these are the negative treatment combinations. So here we form one table in which we have positive sign treatment combinations and negative sign treatment combination. So when we consider AB as a confounded effect, in this effect positive sign treatment combinations are ABC, AB, C and 1. Negative sign treatment combinations are AC, BC, A and B. So this is for confounded effect AB. So in second replicate we confound interaction effect AB, AC. So first write down formula for interaction effect AC. So it is 1 by 4 A minus 1 B plus 1 into C minus 1. It can be written as 1 by 4 ABC minus BC minus AB plus B plus AC minus C minus A plus 1. So with the help of this expression, write down positive and negative sign treatment combinations. So here we get positive treatment combinations are ABC, AC, B and 1. And negative sign treatments are BC, AB, C and A. So these are the 2 interactions effect which we confound partially in replicate 1 and replicate 2. So here also we have randomization, and this randomization is at 2 stages. So for replicate 1, stage 1 is apply positive treatment and negative group of treatment combination in block 1 and block 2 at random in each replicate. Okay, so we randomly assign positive and negative groups to, in block 1 and block 2. And in stage 2 So here we confound AB on replicate 1. Okay, so suppose positive group is assigned to block 1, then apply this ABC, AB, C and 1 at random in the 4 experimental units of block 1. So here we have 2 factorial experiment. So we divide this replicate 1 into 2 blocks in block 1. So block 1, we divide this block 1 into 4 experimental units. And we assign this positive treatment, positive group to this block 1. And similarly, we assign this negative group to block 2. Then we apply this treatment combinations AC, BC, A and B at random in the 4 experimental units of block 2. So this is for replicate 1. Similarly, in replicate 2, we confound this AC interaction effect. So suppose in this replicate 2, we assign this positive group to block 1, then we apply this ABC, AC, B and 1 at random in the 4 experimental units of block 2. Okay, so if we confound AC in block 2, in replicate 2, then we assign positive group to block 1 and negative group to block 1. Okay, so here negative group is assigned to block 1, then we apply BC, AB, C and A at random in the 4 experimental units of block 1. Positive group is assigned to block 2 and negative group is assigned to block 1 for replication 2. So here we get model layout like this. So in replicate 1, positive group is assigned to block 1 and negative group is assigned to block 2. Here we get model layout like this. So in replication 1, we consider AB as a confounded effect and we assign positive group to block 1 and negative group to block 2. So we get design like this: C, AB, ABC and 1. Here we get BC, AC, A and B. Similarly, in replication 2, we confound AC. Okay. So in block 1 we assign negative group and in block 2 we assign positive group. So in replication 1 we get design BC, AB, C and A. These are the negative treatment combination, and B, AC, ABC and 1. These are the treatment combinations with positive sign. So in this way we get model layout when we assign interaction effect, or when we consider when we confound interaction effect AB and AC partially. Okay. So your homework is consider 4 replications and confound all interaction effect partially into that 4 replication and write down this model layout. So next we will discuss statistical analysis of this 2q factorial experiment when we consider ABC as a totally confounded effect in our replicates. Okay, so we have already discussed ABC as a totally confounded effect in 1 replicate and 4 replicate. So here we consider analysis with our replicates. So in this analysis, first we define hypothesis. So our first hypothesis is H01 confounding is not effective versus H11 confounding is effective. Okay. So we test this first hypothesis. After that we have hypothesis for main effect and interaction effect. So H0A is main effect is not significant versus H1A. Main effect A is significant. H0B, main effect B is not significant versus main effect B is significant. Then H0AB, interaction effect AB is not significant versus H1AB, interaction effect AB is significant. And for main effect C, H0C is main effect C is not significant versus H1C, main effect C is significant. H0AC, interaction effect AC is not significant versus interaction effect AC is significant. For third, first order interaction effect H0BC, interaction effect BC is not significant versus H1BC interaction effect BC is significant. So here we consider ABC as a totally confounded effect. That's why we delete that effect from all our replicates. Okay. Suppose we know that after interaction of three fertilizers, that is after interaction of three fertilizers ABC, there is no positive results we get. And if we know this in advance, then we use confounding technique to test this type of hypothesis. Okay. So here, first we discuss sum of squares. So we have we know formulas for total sum of square and sum of square due to block. So total sum of square is, here we have 8 treatment combinations. So I is running from 1 to 8. Since each replicate is divided into 2 blocks, okay. So here J is running from 1 to 2R, or here we can consider 1R because here we consider 8 treatments. And total sum of square is xij square minus x dot dot bar square, or xij minus x dot dot bar bracket square. And simple formula is xij square minus correction factor. So we can use this formula to find total sum of square. Then second formula is sum of square due to block. So it is denoted by SSB. And it can be written as 1 by 4 summation j is running from 1 to 2r x dot j square, that is jth block, the total of jth block square minus correction factor x dot dot square divided by 8r. So since here we consider 8 replicates and we have r replicates and we have 8 treatment combinations, so total number of observations are 8 into r. So here we consider summation j is running from 1 to 2r. So size of each block is 4. So that's why we divide 1 by 4. Okay, we divide 4 to this term. Okay. Then third is SSA, that is sum of square due to main effect A. And it is a factorial effect total for main effect A square divided by total number of observations, that is 8r. Then next is SSB is square bracket B square divided by 8R. SSC is C square divided by 8R. SSAB is AB bracket square divided by 8R. SSAC is AC square divided by 8R. SSBC is BC square divided by 8R. So since we use total confounding and we consider ABC is totally confounded on R replicates, so we delete effect of that interaction from our study. So that's why here we consider only 8 sum of squares. And if we want to find sum of square due to error, then we use this formula to find sum of square due to error. So SSE equals to SST minus SSB minus SSA minus SSB minus SSC minus SSAB minus SSAC minus SSBC. We use this formula to find SSE. So for this we get ANOVA table. Okay. So here we have sources of variation. In this column we have block effect, main effect A, B, C. Then first order interaction effect AB, AC and BC. So since we consider total confounding, we delete that effect from each replicate, and that's why we are not considering that ABC into our ANOVA table. Okay, that is sources of variation column. Then we have error and total. So degrees of freedom. So here we divide each replicate into 2 blocks. So that's why we consider 2R minus 1 degrees of freedom for block effect. Then for main effect and interaction effect, degrees of freedom is 1. So here for error, we get degrees of freedom 6 into R minus 1. Okay. So here we delete ABC effect from all replicates. So the total we have 8 treatment combinations and we delete ABC effect from all replicates. That's why we total number of treatment remaining total number of treatment combination is only 6 7. So in RBD we know that degrees of freedom for error is t minus 1 into b minus 1. So here b equals to r and t equals to 7. So we get degrees of freedom for error is 6 into r minus 1, and for total it is 8r minus 1. So in second column, third column, we have sum of squares. So these are the different sum of squares for main effect and interaction effect. With the help of this sum of squares, we find mean sum of square. So block effect, it is MSP and SSP divided by 2R minus 1. For main effect A, it is denoted by MSA and it is same as sum of square due to main effect A. Then mean sum of square due to main effect B is SSB. So since we have degrees of freedom 1 for main effect and interaction effect, so mean sum of square is same as sum of square for main effect and interaction effect. So here we get MSAB equals to SSAB upon 1, MSAC equals to SSAC divided by 1, MSBC equals to SSBC upon 1, and MSE is the SSE divided by its degrees of freedom 6 into r minus 1. So with the help of this mean sum of squares, we get variance ratio and it is denoted by capital F. For block effect, it is capital F to the base B and it is MSB divided by MSE. For main effect A, it is FA and it is MSA divided by MSB. For main effect B, it is FB equals to MSB divided by MSE. For main effect C, it is FC equals to MSC upon MSE. For interaction effect AB, it is FAB equals to MSAB upon MSE. FAC equals to MSAC divided by MSE. And for interaction effect BC, it is FBC equals to MSBC divided by MSE. So these are the variance ratio to test above hypothesis. So here, this variance ratio follows F distribution with block degrees of freedom and error degrees of freedom. So this FB follows F distribution with 2R minus 1 degrees of freedom and 6 into R minus 1 degrees of freedom. So how we give conclusion for this? So if this FB is greater than critical value, then we reject our hypothesis that confounding is not effective. Okay? Then if this FA is greater than critical value, that is F with 1 degrees of freedom and 6 into R minus 1 degrees of freedom, then we reject our hypothesis H0A, that is main effect A is not significant. If this FB is greater than critical value, then we reject our hypothesis H0B. Similarly, if this FC greater than critical value, then we reject our H0C. If this FAB is greater than critical value, then we reject hypothesis H0AB. If F of AC is greater than critical value, then we reject our hypothesis H0AC, that is interaction effect AC is not effective. And last is, if this FBC is greater than critical value, then we reject our hypothesis H0BC, that is this interaction effect BC is effective. So this is statistical analysis of partial confounding in 2Q factorial experiment. This is a total confounding, and in this case we consider ABC as a totally confounded effect on our replicates. Thank you.